Breaking news right now for you. We're just now learning that Vice President Mike Pence has been called back to the White House for an undisclosed emergency.
Pence was en route to New Hampshire for a previously scheduled opioid event. There were people there waiting in Salem, New Hampshire.
Speech to 200 people, many of whom were in the room waiting when they were told by a representative from Pence's office that Air Force Two had turned around due to, quote, an emergency call back, and that the VP was heading back to Washington, D.C.
All we know, it was described as an emergency, and that Air Force Two was then diverted. He was on his way to an event that was happening in Salem, New Hampshire, and that event has now been canceled.
And Sarah, what are you hearing? Is everything okay?
Well, Kate, we're still getting more information about why Vice President Mike Pence is not going to make it to that opioid event in Manchester, New Hampshire that was scheduled for this early afternoon. But a source close to the vice president tells CNN that Vice President Pence was called back to the White House today, but says that it's no cause for alarm. The vice president's office says this event in New Hampshire will be rescheduled.
My understanding from a bunch of people is that it had something to do with some kind of issue with the venue, some kind of security issue that got flagged.
According to Pence's press secretary, quote, something came up that required the vice president to remain in Washington, D.C. It's no cause for alarm. The vice president never left Washington, D.C. There was no emergency call back. A source close to Pence tells NBC News that the cancellation was not caused by a medical issue, and his chief of staff told reporters that it was not national security related or a personal or family issue either, adding the public would know what happened, quote, weeks from now.
Mark Short, the vice president's chief of staff, told reporters that we would know, you know, in a few weeks from now or something to that effect.
Well, that was concerning. What could possibly be so urgent? The vice president would have to race back to the White House. Reporters, of course, started digging, but all we got was a series of denials. The White House said there was, quote, no cause for alarm, no medical issue with either the president or vice president, not a national security issue, not a personal or family issue, and my favorite, someone will not be fired soon.
It's unusual because Pence is normally the person who is seen as sort of the force of stability in this administration, and so to have him show up on a plane and get on a plane and then deplane and not go and not hear what happened, it prompted all kinds of conspiracy theories, you know.
During this whole time, the president's Twitter account was dark. 6 hours and no tweets. People were worried. What was happening? Where was the president? Finally, 6:05 p.m. Eastern Time, Donald Trump surfaced with a big announcement. Quote, thanks to Phantom Fireworks and Fireworks by Grucci for their generosity in donating the biggest fireworks show Washington, D.C. has ever seen! Exclamation point. Well, I guess he's okay.
There was one question which was going around for a while of, is the president really going to go ahead with what the Wall Street Journal suggested and change him off the ticket right now? I don't think it was any of those things. But I think it is another one of these issues where, because of how it was handled, it is made into a far bigger problem.